How to install WordPress step by step. Hello WordPress enthusiasts and welcome to our channel. My name is Robert and in this video I will show you how to install this fabulous content management system in cPanel and create your first website fast. You have three options for using WordPress. WordPress.com, WordPress.org, where you can download the software and use its powerful features for free on unlimited domains, and also locally on your PC. The last one is for those of you who want to test the themes and plugins fast, without the limitations of an internet connection. But in this video, I will focus only on how to install the software from WordPress.org through your cPanel on your domain with hosting bought from Siteground.com, which is one of the best hosting providers out there. You are free to use any other hosting provider. There are so many possibilities, but from my experience as a WordPress website owner, it is a very good choice. First of all, click the link in the description to get a massive discount for WordPress hosting. Enter the name for the domain you want to register and complete all the steps until you get the message "Proceed to the customer area." Now you can access your user account and easily install WordPress from cPanel or by using the new interface offered by Siteground, which makes it even more comfortable. After only a couple of clicks, you will be ready to access your site's dashboard and play with its settings. When using the standard cPanel, which powers most of the web servers out there, you need to go to the WordPress installer in WordPress Tools over here. Some providers might name this menu differently, and you need to look for Softaculous Apps Installer. To avoid this confusion, search for WordPress Installer in the search panel. Next, click on the WordPress tool and select the Quick or the Custom Install under the Install tab. The Quick Install will give you options for choosing the WordPress version, installation URL, and dashboard admin credentials. If you want to access things like site name, description, and other advanced options before installing WordPress, make sure you choose the custom install way. What you need to do next is to choose the domain you want WordPress to be installed on, the HTTPS protocol, which will allow using an SSL certificate to encrypt the communication between your server and your visitor's browser. This is mandatory for data security and SEO. I will show you how to use Let's Encrypt on Siteground to install a free SSL certificate fast, so keep watching. Next, fill out all the fields below carefully with your site's name, description, and so on. Choose a username and a strong password, then insert your admin email here. Select the language and the plugins you want to start with. I would recommend starting simple with a clean installation and adding additional tools later if needed. In the advanced options below, you can set the name of your database or leave it as it is by default. Choosing a custom name for your database will help you quickly recognize it later if needed. A maximum of 7 letters is allowed in the database name field, and you can change the table prefix too, it's up to you. Choose the backup location in this drop-down. I leave it as it is by default every time I install WordPress on a new domain. I also prefer to backup my sites manually to make sure that I have something in my hand, if the files on the hosting server will disappear for no reason. Just click on Install below whenever you are ready and wait a couple of seconds until the process ends. If everything goes well, you'll be prompted that WordPress was installed successfully and you can access the website by clicking on this link or your admin URL, which will open the dashboard. There you have it. WordPress is on now and you can start by replacing the default theme with something better. For example, you can try installing Neve and then import one of its starter sites. If you are creating a site for a tattoo shop, import this demo and customize it as you want with Elementor. You can easily change everything, like text, images, and so on, without touching a single line of code. The visual editor interface of Elementor is so user-friendly and intuitive. I promised I would show you how to add a free SSL certificate to your domain name. Well, you can use the lazy way and contact the Siteground team to do it for you. But if you are the action type guy and you want to do it yourself, go back to the cPanel and search Let's Encrypt over here. Click on the app, then choose the domain you want to install an SSL certificate on. Stay with the simple one, then click the Install button below. You'll see a pop-up window that says SSL is successfully installed. Click OK and you're all set. Now you can check it out live on your website. If your domain is new or bought from another register, you need to wait around 20 minutes or even more until you see it live on your browser. My connection is secure on Chrome, for example, because I have a valid SSL certificate. Let's see what's happening if I cancel the SSL certificate in my Siteground account. If I reload the page now, I get the 404 error message, which means that my site isn't working the way it should be. So let's go back and install the SSL certificate again. So easy, right? I remember that years ago, WordPress could be installed only manually by uploading all the files from WordPress.org through FTP. Then I had to create a database for it and take care of the manual installation when accessing the site for the first time. Now it is much comfortable, and with the new user interface on Siteground, it is easier like never before. For example, if I create a new test subdomain in the site tools over here, I can go to WordPress after the domain is generated. Now I need to click on Install and Manage. Select WordPress, the test subdomain, language, and admin info, then I only have to click on Install below. That's it. Now you know how to install WordPress. If you have questions, leave a comment below and I will answer each of you guys. Feel free to check out other videos on our channel and make sure to subscribe so you won't miss any future videos I publish. See you in the next one. Cheers! Thank you.